What is up everyone, T-Man out here, welcoming you back to another video. It's not much, but it's mine. Tonight, I'm finally doing a desk setup tour. I've talked about a number of things that are on my desk, like my M1 Mac Mini, my keyboard, my monitor light bar, and all those things. Even the journey of my, I mean not the journey, but the transformation of my desk from last year to this year. But tonight, we will be doing the full desk tour. But before anything else, I noticed recently that a lot of my viewers are not subscribed to the channel. So if you're watching this, please smash a subscribe button as it would help make things run a bit smoother around here. Okay, let's go. Starting things off with the desk. This desk is called the Office Desk 301 from a company called Offix. They're a local company here in the Philippines. So if you're from the Philippines and you want this desk, I have the link down below to their website. I opted for a deeper desk because I didn't really have much room for a long desk because my room is just full of windows and cabinets, so I don't have that much wall space. So I had to go with something deeper so I can put the stuff that I need on the desk itself. And in the topic of saving space, I opted to mount my monitor on an arm mount. So this is the Loop Alloy single arm monitor mount that is supporting my 32-inch LG monitor. This monitor has good colors. It's not the most accurate colors, but it's good enough for what I do, for my videos, for my photo editing, though I really want to have it calibrated soon. So I really enjoy this monitor. It's a Type-C port for the display port, so you can just plug in the included Type-C cable and just run it down to the Thunderbolt port on your Mac Mini or in my Mac Mini. Now that Mac Mini is actually my computer of choice for editing photos, editing videos. I posted a full review like last month, I think, or a couple of weeks ago. You can check out the link up here. Okay, so for my speakers of choice, I'm using the Xiaomi Redmi TV soundbar. It's a Bluetooth soundbar. It sounds great for watching movies, just chilling, listening to music. It's good enough. I don't use it to edit any videos. That's why I opted for a soundbar. It looks cleaner on the desk, in my opinion. And it just lessens the cable, the stress of cable management and all of those things. So for editing, I use my Sony headphones. And my Sony headphones is the WH-1000XM Mark II. So it's two generations behind. The XM4 is out. I think the XM5 will be coming out soon as well. But I don't feel the need yet to upgrade. These still sound great. Great battery life. It has great noise cancellation. It's very comfortable and it does the job very well for what I needed to do. And I just don't feel the need to upgrade yet. That's just money I don't want to spend just yet. For my peripherals, I have the Keychron K2 version 2. If you want to see a review, I'll leave the link up here and I'll link it to the description down below. But I love this keyboard. It feels good when you're typing. It's very compatible with the Mac, the layouts, and it has actually a Mac mode and a Windows mode. So that's great. So if I opt to use it for my work laptop, I can still do that. And as for backup, for if I forget to charge the Keychron, I have a backup keyboard. This is the IQNIX F96. For my mouse, I'm using the Logitech G304. I like how comfortable the G304 is on my hand. So I really like that for me, and that's what I need in a mouse, is for it to be comfortable, especially when you're editing long hours. You're editing photos, videos for hours and hours and hours. So I also have here customized wood wrist rest. So I had this customized. I found a vendor in Facebook Marketplace, so it still has my old logo on it. And having a wrist rest just gives you a more comfortable typing position than not having it, and I enjoy having it. I can't live without a wrist rest anymore. Underneath it all is my leather desk mat. Again, this is generic, it's brandless. I just found it on Facebook Marketplace. I bought it for like, I think 250 pesos or like $5. So it's a pretty good value for money. It limits the scratching on the table, so it works as a mouse pad as well, and it's a pretty good accent that gives my setup a little bit more character. Now over to the side of my desk, the side right here. First, I have a tumbler, of course, gotta stay hydrated. And I also have my MagSafe charger mounted on a generic cell phone holder. Yes, a generic cell phone holder that I got for like $3, 150, 160 pesos. I love how convenient it is to have the MagSafe on the mount. So for example, you're just working and working and your phone is low battery, you just slide it on there and it charges automatically, and it's on the mount. It's easier to pull as compared to when it's just on the table. It's kind of harder to remove the MagSafe charger. You have to two-hand it, as compared to when you have that mount, you can just slide it off again. Under the realm of chargers, I also have my Apple Watch charger here, a charger for my work phone, the Samsung A31, and a charger for my headphones. And I also use it to charge my Sony batteries for when I'm shooting video, so I always have extra batteries. I also use the Type-C cable to charge my keyboards, both the IQNX one and the Keychron one. For storage, I have a 6 terabyte hard drive, for mostly for just backup and storage. So if there are files that I'm not using anymore, I just dump it all there. I label it properly, so if I need some b-roll that I can use for another video, I can just pull him up from there and just have it available for my disposal. As for storage, the table doesn't come with any drawer, so I don't have a lot of like things that I would like to store in a drawer, so I've just opted for a tabletop organizer. So I found this over in Lazada. It's like 170 pesos a piece. It's a great, it's stackable, you can just throw your whatever you need in there. So I use these drawers for different things. I have drawers for my notebooks, my pens, and some personal items. And I also use this for my camera gear, smaller camera gear like tripod plates, extra batteries, my battery charger. I have different things on here like my memory cards, extra Type-C cables, just everything that I need to be within reach. And what's cool is on top of the drawer, there's like a pocket that you can put things that you need to access easier. Like I have my AirPods there, so for and when I have Zoom meetings on my computer, I can just pop them in. I have my wallet, I have my eyeglasses up there, so it's really great to have that storage. And speaking of storage, on either side of the table as well, I have 2 pencil drawers. In one, I store batteries. I just unpacked a couple of packs and just put them in there. And on the other side, these are more personal things like inhalers, essential oils for headache, for helping me to go to sleep and things like that, which is great. So going underneath the table, my cable management, I actually have my card reader mounted underneath the desk, and I just have the cable routed to my USB hub using cable clips, and my USB hub is connected directly to the Mac Mini M1. I also have a cable tray down here. It is where I keep my power brick and the power supply of my monitor, and I use this also to tuck in some wires just so it would look a bit cleaner. And if you see, most of my cables are routed with cable clips and double-sided tape just for it to look cleaner. It doesn't look perfect from down here, from this angle, but from where I'm sitting, it looks clean and, you know, out of sight, out of mind. Also, before I forget, I have my microphone tucked in behind the monitor, so if I'm not using it, I can just fold it up and just put it there. It's in a boom arm, and my microphone is the Samsung Q2U. It's a dynamic microphone, that's why I have to have it close to my mouth. So okay, there you have it, guys. That's my desk setup. So if you have suggestions to make it better, to make it more efficient in terms of productivity, please do leave your suggestions in the comment section down below. And I hope you really enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit the like button, smash the subscribe, and punch that notification bell so you're notified every time I have a new video. Thank you guys for watching. That is it for me tonight. Peace out.